Ja, yeah, Smart Wargames hier. While looking for a specific mobile game, I stumbled on a Wargaming series called Conflict Series. Depicting operational warfare in World War I, World War II, and yeah, Civil War, I also saw, and perhaps other conflicts. You can check it out on the Google Play Store. It is for mobiles. I myself am not that much of a mobile gamer, but I'm pretty sure some of you might be. And looking for good war games, we already checked out some of the John Tiller games, and it seems like a developer named Nutinen, perhaps I spelled that wrong, is also providing wargaming on mobiles. Yeah, that is the list, at least on Google Play. Not sure if it is available on iOS. And what do we have here? We have Africa, we have the Pacific, Eastern Front, Western Front, ah, exactly, Korean War, American Revolutionary War. So it's not only the Civil War, Normandy 44, Berlin, and so basically the entire World War II are here. Spanish Civil War, Kharkov, Saipan, Barbarossa, Army Group Center, Okinawa, Invasion of Italy, Mediterranean, Invasion of Poland, Kursk, France is depicted, the early World War II, Sea Line, the fictional invasion of Great Britain, which never happened, but you can play it here in a what if. Finnish Defense 44. Yeah, a lot of operations here for you to choose, and some, yeah, American Civil War. However, yeah, as you see the price, they are all go for $5. But the reviews seem to be good, people seem to be happy, and there's a way to try it out. If you check the developer's page, yeah, conflictseries.com, I added it in the description. You can read more about the individual games, and there is also a free link, which I won't press now. It will bring you to the Amazon App Store. So if you have an Amazon account, you can log into this App Store and download, I guess, some sort of test versions of almost every game for free and check it out if it is yours before you commit. Yeah, that's what I did. I downloaded two. I will showcase them a bit so you can make your own opinion. I have a Civil War one and I have a World War II one. I think that is a good contrast. Let's check out Case Blue. Yeah, that was the big offensive of the Germans on the Eastern Front, which led to the Battle of Stalingrad. Let's start from up to low. Short written tutorial. That is a hex-based war game. As mentioned in the title. Yeah, and the music is from me. Not sure if this game has... It has sounds, I hear the clicking noise. But I guess mobile games, if you play this somewhere and play a war game, perhaps it's even better when the acoustics are low profile. Yeah, and they look accessible. Yeah, sure, you need to dig a bit about those RMPs, for example. Yeah, check them out. There are some generals depicted, leadership, fuel. Okay, yeah, that is now that is good. I like it that there is that is quite extensive. That is good. For the showcase video, we will now skip that and I will check out the game for myself, but definitely make sure that to read that. In order to show you the size, and you see there's real leadership depicted. That is nice detail. Yeah, let's zoom out. That is quite a huge map. And I'm running this on an emulator, so the performance on real devices. But you can also play it on an emulator. You can log in with your real accounts, whatever you want. If you, for example, want to play it on PC. As far as I saw, there's no PC port. Yeah, but the amount of. Okay, it gets bigger. That is. Yeah, there is even bigger operations, there are smaller operations, but the amount of counters is, I would say, low to medium compared to other games, yeah, so it is quite manageable. Back in. Remove some units around. Where do we want to start? I already can. Easier. You can also use the keyboard. Okay, here we have some panzers. Get all that stuff. Okay, we lost some movement because we run into a forest. We've bypassed it. Yeah, movement is happening one by one, and you see stuff like crossing rivers is costing action points. You know, like last. Okay, yeah, this Jimmy, you don't need. Okay, we made contact here. Can we attack immediately to show you the combat? No, next turn. But we could attack here. I don't think that is a good idea. Because I guess that is a strength value. You see some units carry special resources, like pontoon bridge. Bridges in order to cross without or with less movement penalty. There's some tactic. It seems like you can set units to something like a doctrine to a stance, which will give them bonuses and yeah. Okay, let's attack here, see how combat resolution is looking. Yeah, commander, there's some commander in command radius, I guess that is a command radius. And a Soviet commander. Yeah, okay. That is a battle resolution, it is nothing super but it does the trick. And yeah, some fuel management. Let's see if the Romanians can enter. We have some Stuka support. Bombard them. Let's see if the Romanians can get into. I see you need to watch out here. Another stack, and we made it. But we didn't break them. Okay, so this will be delayed. get our generals to the front lines. Not enough movement points. This might bring a commander into the vicinity here first. Yeah, I mean, I have almost no tanks here. See if this works out. Ah, okay, misclick. Yeah, that looks quite strong. Yeah, operational experience, especially that is a tough nut to crack for the Germans, is, of course, as they already lost to some extent the initiative on the Eastern Front, but you can try exploit it and see if you can do better. The real operation, yeah, most extent failed and resulted in the catastrophe of Stalingrad. But perhaps you can do better. Good, that is World War II title, and yeah, there was also a World War I title. Now let's check out the American Civil War, how that looks. Okay, that is a different appearance. Lower unit amounts, as expected. Also quite a map. It reminds me from the visuals a bit like Advanced Tactics or the games by of the Decisive series. Contact. I like that they play so small if you have immobile, okay. If you have multi-counters that are pretty convenient. I don't know how it is on mobile with fingers and whatever, but you see in the emulation with the mouse, it works pretty good. And yeah, if you want to play it on the PC, I think it is very convenient. Especially when using the arrow keys here in this MIMO. You can also run it full screen. Then it is basically like a PC game. In case you need for some accessible war game of a specific battle, which perhaps is not depicted by dedicated PC titles, or you simply like the style of the gameplay here. Okay. Yeah, and then you can also press this button. Oh, we have a train. Transport. Is that working? Ah, I knew it. I wanted to select another unit. Load. Ah, okay. That was quite straightforward. Yes, I know that is strange, but on the other hand, perhaps it isn't. We drove there and loaded those guys and now bringing them forward. Out of movement points. Enough train for today. You even have a riverboat. That is interesting, okay? So you can drive along those hexes, I guess. That is a nice concept. That is not often I saw something like that. Riverine action in those games. Yeah, sure. Was a thing. Yeah, I wonder how those should have downloaded a Pacific game. See if there is, or they are depicted, perhaps. I would imagine you have also some maritime or amphibious support. Okay, yeah, check it out. And I will check out another one now. Yeah, good hunting.